So we're going to roll right into working with starting to shade some boxes. So using light source. So we're going to set it up similar to this, except we'll be using just probably drawing pencils, and we'll use some different techniques in this because it is easier to use techniques such as hatching, cross-hatching, and stippling with boxes and stuff that will all have panels kind of the same color or shade versus spheres, which are a little bit harder. So to begin with, I'm going to go ahead and write my notes at the top just so I can remember and try to get it ingrained in our heads. So when we're working with light sources, they're going to create a highlight, a shadow. I can't spell shadow today. A-D-O-W. And a cast or drop shadow. Okay, so boxes you can draw several different ways. And so again, we're going to focus on practicing with five different ones. And so these don't have to be huge. And they don't have to be precise. And so I'll start with one there. I'll draw one here in the center. That's going to be the other direction. I'm going to draw one over here. That seeing more of the corner, kind of draw it a little bit more in perspective. So like 2-point perspective versus then like seeing the top or the bottom. One from a kind of like a bird's eye view. And one more kind of normal box here. Alright, so again, it's kind of a good reminder when you're working with a light source and you're not, especially when you're practicing, you're not quite sure to draw kind of like a little sun with some rays coming off of it. So this one, I think I'm going to light from this side. And so when working with a light source, you're going to have your light source. The part of your object that is closest to your light source is going to be your highlight. So I think I'll really only divide these boxes into like two sections if my highlight is on that side. And then you're going to have your shadow, which is going to be your darkest area. And then your cast shadow. So cast shadows happen when like it's the shape of the object falling onto your ground, or if it's sitting on like a table. So this one will light from above. So our highlight's going to be in this corner. And then on down, so these both are kind of going to be in shadow. And then we'll have a short little shadow right here, again, in kind of the shape of our box. This one, let's light it from above. So this is probably going to be our highlight. Your darker area here. So this would probably be a little bit darker. And then the most dark here with your shadow coming off from there. This box kind of from here. So like the sides that you can't see. So if we were drawing this one, like it would be like your major highlight. So this is going to be slightly larger. slightly darker than your highlight, this is going to be your darkest because it's the furthest away, and this would have a good bit of shade to it. And so shadow there. This one will light from like ground level. So highlight, a little bit of shadow, a little bit of shadow, probably your darker over here, and like the back side would be the darkest. But so your shadow would fall up there. Okay, so for these, the drawing pencils do work a little bit better because you can work specifically with your ranges. So fully like normal shading will work with this one. So I'll kind of just lay my pencil down. So this is the 4H. So it's a very hard pencil. So you can hear it, like it's not very soft. It's not, it's taking a lot to kind of leave that value. And so if I press a little bit harder, like it's not getting much darker. But I want to blend that out so it's a little bit smooth. And I'll fix my corner there. So 4Hs will usually look very bandy. They're not, depending on how you shade with them. And of course, you can always go back in, kind of touch it up with a blender or your eraser or both. So the 4B, if I press a little bit harder, like it's going to give me a little darker of a value. But so I'll use it to kind of finish out the front face of the box. So in the center here, I can use my blender in like a circular motion, or go in and kind of create stripes. And then I can go back in with my eraser and touch it up because it's a tad bit too dark. And then really go in with that soft side there. So again, these aren't going to be perfect. They're just kind of practice. But I can go in and feather that back out a little bit. And blend that just a little bit more. Okay, so that's the lightest side of my box. So the darker side, I'm going to go in with the 4B and kind of make that corner nice and sharp on the dark side. And then kind of finish this up with the 6B over here in the corner. So if you're dealing in like with a glass box, boxes won't really have as much reflected light, but if you were working with like a glass box, it would likely be on this edge right here. And then your shadow. So right there where the light side of the box touches the shadows, like you can get a real nice dark detail. And then just go in with your blender. And kind of blend again, you can always touch up your lines with your eraser. And you can fan out the shadow if you want. And again, just kind of play with the pushing and pulling to get it where you want it. So again, kind of taking the eraser and making that little top line real nice and neat. And you can do the same thing if you want a little bit of reflected light, and so that you can really tell where the bottom of that shadow or the bottom of your box is. And I'll go ahead and clean up this side as well. So I took a little too much of my shadow, but that's nothing I can't add back in. Alright. So boxes, comparatively easier than spheres. Alright, so this one here, I'm actually going to do a little bit differently. So I'm going to work with the mechanical pencil and just kind of show you the differences. So this is the 0.5 lead, and so I can shade in there really nice. It's depositing a lot of color very easily, but it is perhaps a little too dark for my light side. So I'm going to go in and go ahead and blend it a bit. And so like something like a building or something that's already dark, like that would be fine. But I want to go in and make it a little bit lighter, which is probably doing the push and pull of lights and darks is probably the hardest thing about this, is trying to get it enough without being too much and making it not look like it's banding. So I'm actually kind of pretty happy with that. And again, it's just a lot of practice. The more you do it, the more comfortable you'll be with it. So these sides here, I'm going to outline a little bit, so they're going to be a little bit darker. And again, if your box ends up a little wobbly, it's fine. And then since both of these are probably about equally away from the light source, they're going to be about the same shade. And you can go in and kind of make one side just a little bit darker so you can really tell where those sides are. And then of course your shadow. Clean up those edges with my eraser, kind of make it a lot, the shadow a lot crisper if I don't want it to be feathery. And then I can also go in and kind of add that little bit of reflected light. That way the shadow or the box really stands out from that shadow. And again, I'm just kind of rubbing the eraser against my pants, or you can use like the palm of your hand to get it a little bit cleaner, so that you can get those nice crisp eraser lines. Alright, so let's see, this one was mechanical. I'll darken that side up just a wee bit more. Drawing pencils. Blend that out just a little bit more. And so, I mean, you can always, as you see something you do on one, you can go back to the others that you work on. Okay, so this one here, I'm going to try something a little bit different. So I'll just do it with the mechanical pencils. This one will be hatching. So hatching lines are essentially just parallel lines right next to each other. The further apart you place them, the more white it lets in, the lighter the value. The closer you put them together, the darker your value is going to be, and you can overlap them, as well as the harsher that you make your lines in the first place. So with this one, I'm just going to add a little bit of hatching lines to the top, and kind of leave this almost white over here. And so this corner is going to be my darkest. So for this, make this panel a little bit darker by going in and just using lines. Go in and shade that, and I probably should have actually done that sideways. Again, I mean, drawing is, if you don't like how it looks, just erase it and try again. There's no right or wrong way to do things. So you can tell there's still just lines. You can go with the movement of the box. But so that's probably going to be my darker side. And then you can either basically fill it with stripes, or you can go in and kind of make shorter strokes and do it that way. But so I'm going to actually, I'm going to make this side the darker one, so I'll just go in and just keep layering those hatching lines. And if you're watching this specifically for the class video, you don't need to. You can do all of these in just drawing pencils or like the mechanical pencil, and you don't have to try these. But if you want to push yourself by all means. Give it a shot. See what you like, see what you don't like. But if you were working with something like pen or wanting to add like texture, make it look like wood panels or something, like you would most likely be using hatching of some sort. And so hatching, you can also vary your direction to kind of follow the planes of the surface. And so my shadow here, I'm going to try to make as dark as I can. And kind of follow the direction of the light. So that one, I'm not going to really feather out the box or the shadow or anything, but I can make this top section just a little bit darker. So depending on what you're doing, the look you're going for, you might use that. Most things you'll probably stick with like trying to blend it out, make it a little more smoother, a little more realistic. So this one, I'm going to go ahead and do with cross-hatching. So cross-hatching is simply doing a line of hatching and then crossing over top of it. So this one is again probably going to be our darkest side, so I'm going to start there this time and actually place my lines like that, and then go back in, and this one's gonna look a little neater than, and get a easier range of value than the hatching lines. But so cross hatching, you can also do like maybe 3 layers, 4 layers, 5 layers, depending on what you're going for. You're not just limited to 2. So for the shadow there, actually go ahead and start on it. So I'll do one layer. So this was 3. So one layer, this will be 2. Three straight across. And 4 up and down. So you can kind of see where or how that is slightly darker than the side there, because it has one more. I think I will go ahead and just do one more layer kind of in between some of those. So those are my darker values. So this side, this one had 2. This one, I'll go in, that side had 3. This one I'll go in and probably just do two. Actually, I want this side to be a little bit darker. So I'll kind of just leave it that. And so for the top, this will be your lightest. So I'll go in with some patching. And then some. A little bit of the crossing there. And so this does need to be a little bit darker. And then just kind of square up the box. And again, you can always add more or use your eraser. So, cross-hatching box, yeah, that does look. Top is a little bit lighter, or you could space those out even more and make it a little bit softer. Make that side just a little bit darker. That's so by space the lines out, not have. Alright, so this last one here, I apologize for the sound, but so it's stippling or pointillism, and this is going to be your dots. So essentially, like, you can draw your dots, but they work better if they're filled in. But so very lightly, like the closest side would have not a whole lot of dots. This top section would have more placed a lot closer together. Gonna switch to the 6B for this one, so on the side, so that I can get them darker dots and a bit closer together. So if you're working with something like pen or engraving, depending on the look you're going for, you might use stippling, hatching, or cross hatching. But depending on the look that you're going for, generally just the full shading might look, be the easiest, look the best, kind of thing. And so for the shadow, I'll try to get even a little bit darker. So even if you're not using the stippling, hatching, and cross-hatching for these, and just decide to go in and shade them, the same technique, well, same kind of coloring situation still applies. So you will always have your light source with your highlight. And then your darkest will be your shadow, and then your cast shadow. Alright, that's it for this video. You guys stay safe, have fun, and make some stuff. Bye.